It seems that developers hate WordPress. So in this video, I'm going to tell you why they're right and why they're wrong. Hello, I'm your host Casino from Casino.com. I'm the digital alchemist, and in this video, we're going to talk about why developers hate WordPress. So I'm going to tell you why they're right, and if you want to know why they're wrong, make sure you watch until the end. So developers hate WordPress, huh? So let's discuss about why they are right. Well, first of all, it may sound obvious, but they love coding, not installing plugins. So I was talking to a developer the other day, and he was telling me that he had to work on a WordPress project, and he felt so frustrated. So frustrated because basically he wanted to code, and all he had to do is install plugins, install a theme, and just configure the plugins. And that was really frustrating for him because he told me that he actually codes faster than he writes. So if he had to write a letter, he codes faster, and he loves coding. He loves the challenges that comes with coding. So just installing plugins is a really, really big frustration. And if you are a web designer, try to imagine the opposite. Just imagine that all you love to do is just design, and then you work on a project where all the design is done and you don't have to touch anything about design. How would you feel? Next, WordPress is slow, or at least slower than a hand-coded website. I mean, if the code was good, of course. And it's true. Let's face it. If you need to create a simple website, so let's say we're talking about a 5-page website or even a 10-page website, just a static website, sometimes what's the point of having a database? Because basically what happens is that when you actually request the assets, it goes through the database, so there's a constant back and forth, and that makes it slower. And on top of that, WordPress can also be bloated because you have everything that's in the core, and then you add some plugins and some more plugins, and at the end of the day, you have many things that you actually don't need within the website. And that's why developers are frustrated, because they want to build something that's efficient and that's going to work fast. And they feel like WordPress is slowing them down. And sometimes it's really true. Now, there are solutions. There are solutions for WordPress, so you can make your website way faster. And I've seen and I've managed to make some websites really, really fast. But it's like starting the other way around, because it should be start from the get-go. And instead here, it's slower, and then you need to make it faster. But if we only reduce WordPress to this, it's not really fair, because WordPress comes with many, many other features, and all in all, it can make for a good solution. And we'll talk about that in the second part of this video. But yes, that can be a frustrating point. Next, WordPress maintenance can be a nightmare. So if you have a lot of plugins, it can be a nightmare. I've seen some websites with 30, 40, 50 plugins, and I know what you're going to say. This is bad practice. You should have 5 plugins, or even less, or less than 10 plugins. But that's becoming more and more hard to actually achieve, because what happens is that sometimes for one plugin, you have 4 add-ons, and each add-on is considered as a plugin. We don't get to decide that. I don't know why developers do that. I mean, those creating the plugins and selling the plugins, but that's the way it goes. You get Elementor, and then you get Elementor Pro. And in that case, it makes sense because you get a free plugin, so Elementor, and then you get the Pro plugin. So at least, okay. But for some plugins, on the top of my mind, I think it's LoginPress. For each add-on, it adds a new plugin. So if you want 5 features activated, you have 5 plugins. And some complex websites, especially websites that come with WooCommerce and many, many other add-ons, they're a nightmare to maintain, because if you just hit update all, that's the best way to break your website. Whereas when you just code a website, you know what you did and you don't need as much maintenance. And that brings me to my next point, which is security. Because security can also be a nightmare. Because if you have many, many plugins, and if it's a nightmare to maintain and you cannot update all, like each and every day, on some websites, you just log in and you just did the update the day before, and now you have 6 more plugins to update. So if you don't want to break your website, you need to wait and maybe do it, I don't know, once a week, once a month, once every other week. It depends. It depends on the scenario. And that means that you can leave some loopholes just open on your website. And that's the best way to get hacked. Whereas when you create a website from scratch, when it's hand-coded, you know what you did, and it's going to be way easier to secure the website and make it harder to get in. Whereas with WordPress, hackers know how to get in and when there's an exploit, and all they need to do is to target all the websites with the exploit still available. So, which means with the plugins not updated or the theme not updated. Next, developers feel like WordPress is not suited for complex projects. For example, if you want to create a very complex web app, it may not be the best thing to do. Because if you're going to use WordPress, sure, there is a plugin for everything, as they say. But sometimes, like I said, you're going to end up with like 50, 60 plugins, and it's not exactly the solution that the client wanted. It's kind of working, but you know, it's a bit cumbersome, and that's not ideal. So that's why developers prefer to work from a blank page, create each module and making sure that everything works and you don't blow the system, you don't blow the website with many other features, you just code what you need. Okay, next, and this is a big one and you've probably already heard it before. WordPress is not real development. It's drag and dropment. So why do developers say that? Well, like we've said before, sometimes we talk about WordPress developers when actually it's all about installing plugins and themes. And that's why developers who've learned code for weeks, months, years in most cases, they feel like calling someone a WordPress developer maybe is not fair to them because it's not real development. It's installing themes and plugins. And we'll talk a little bit later about that in the video because we need to define what a WordPress developer is. And you see that depending on what you put behind the words, the perspective is completely different. Okay, next, and now we're going to talk about control. Because for developers with WordPress, you're not in control. So usually developers love to use the console log. I'm talking about JavaScript, for example, but you get the idea. They love to debug what they do, be in control, and that must be fast. That must be like snappy. Whereas with WordPress, so you install a plugin, you use a plugin, and then something's wrong and you don't have control. Now, sure, you can always use the inspector and use the console log, try to do debugging within the browser, but then it means that you need to change the plugin, but first you need to understand the logic behind that plugin. And sometimes the logic is very different from one developer to another, and it can be really a pain, it can be a nightmare, it can take a lot more time than if they had coded the feature themselves. So in other words, what developers don't like with WordPress is that they are dependent on other people, whereas a developer prefers to be dependent on himself or herself. Okay, the next point can be as right as wrong, because it's all about WP devs are underpaid. So in other words, for developers, they think that if you are a WordPress developer, you're going to be underpaid compared to what they make. And in most cases, that's true. Because once again, it depends on what is behind the words. If being a WordPress developer means that you just install themes and plugins, then for a company, you could be considered as a commodity. So it's easy to replace you. There are many people on the market with those skills. So they don't need to pay you as much as a Python developer, for example. But we'll talk about that later because it's not always true. And I've seen some WordPress pros make a lot of money. Because you can also create web apps, you can create really beautiful websites, you can create really high-end websites. So it really depends. But what is true though is that if you're looking for a job, so if you're not talking about starting a business, being a freelance, if you're looking for a job from the get-go, salaries for developers are going to be higher than for WordPress professionals. Okay, now let's talk about why developers are wrong about hating WordPress. Well, first of all, you can't code in WordPress. You just don't reinvent the wheel every time. So what you can do, for example, is just install a bare-bone theme and then you can start coding. You can start coding if you're a front-end developer. You can really make it your own and really have fun. I love CSS, and even though I consider myself now a WordPress professional, even though I started as a front-end developer and I'm still a front-end developer, but I work as a WordPress pro, I love CSS, and I use CSS in every project. Now, you can go further than that, but if you're a front-end developer, you can have a lot of fun with WordPress, and it's going to be actually a bit faster because you don't need to reinvent the wheel. all the responsive stuff is already set in place. There are some handy features that are already set in place, and you can really focus on your craft. Okay, so that was you can code in WordPress. And now let's talk about the fact that you can code for WordPress. You can create awesome themes and plugins, and I can name Astra WP, which in my opinion is a fantastic WordPress theme. Even the free version is awesome. So you can get started with the free version. It's got a lot of features, but it's really lightweight, and you can really deactivate all the stuff that you don't need so you don't blow the website. And the pro version is even better. You can white label it. You can do a lot of stuff. It's just amazing. I got a video about that, so make sure you watch it if you want to know why I recommend Astra WP. And the same goes for Elementor Pro. I mean, Elementor comes with a free version, and then you have Elementor Pro. And basically with Elementor Pro, sky's the limit. And if you're a developer and you don't understand why people use Elementor, make sure you watch my video about why I love Elementor Pro. That's the best advice I can give you because I've packed it all in that video. But basically, there are some plugins, some tools like I just mentioned, or CrocoBlock with the Jet Engine plugin that you really need to look at if you're into dynamic websites. Those plugins and those themes were created by developers, right? They were created by developers. So if you are a developer and instead of saying, oh, WordPress is bad and I don't like WordPress, you can make really good money. Just look at websites like Code Canyon. I mean, look at the elite developers. Look at the number of sales they've made. You can make a very good living and you can have fun coding awesome plugins. I could talk about the Amelia plugin for, it's a booking plugin. There are many, many awesome plugins that coders have created for the platform. So if you love coding, you can code for WordPress. Okay, now let's talk about the name WordPress developer. I mentioned that a little bit before. So about the name WordPress developers. Now, depending on whether you think that a WP developer is just a drag and dropper or is a real developer, it's going to be a different perspective. So if in your mind a WordPress developer is a drag and dropper and you don't like that because you are a full-blown, full-stack developer, well, you need to know that first of all, the world has changed. When the web started, you could only code. And then you had some software like Dreamweaver and that kind of stuff that came on the market. But still, you needed some higher skills. But the world has changed. Now, there is WordPress. There are other tools like Webflow. And the world has changed. This is just a reality. So even though you don't like it, there is a market for it. Especially small businesses. Small businesses love those solutions because actually they don't really care about the solution that you're using. They actually don't care at all. But what makes a difference is that it's going to be cheaper because a small mom and pop shop, most of them, they don't have 10K or even 5K for a website. They want the best value they can get. And that's the reality. So for smaller websites, drag and droppers are actually fine. Now, truth be told, I always advise in my videos for people to learn code, at least the basics, HTML, CSS, people should actually learn it. I love CSS, like I said, and I code like almost every day in CSS, which is not really coding, but you get the idea. So because the world has changed, you need to be pragmatic. You need to be pragmatic. And the truth is, clients don't care. So let me make this bigger. Clients don't care. Now, if we're talking about developers, so if by a WP developer, you imply that it's a real developer. First of all, there are many professional tools, and we'll talk about that a little bit later in the video, but there are professional tools, and the ecosystem is going to be key. What do I mean by ecosystem? You need to choose a theme, and then you need to choose a theme builder. I mean, in my opinion, that's the best way to do it. There are many. I always recommend Elementor Pro, but there is Divi, and there is Oxygen, there is Thrive Architect, Beaver Builder, and many others. But these are the big ones. And then you need to choose a set of plugins, and I often recommend CrocoBlock. Like usual, all those tools I talk about, you'll find the affiliate links in the description below. But I only recommend those tools because I actually believe in those tools. I use it every day in my professional life. Now, with a good ecosystem, sky is the limit. And actually, the sky limit just gets higher and higher and keeps getting higher and higher all the time. So basically, with that mindset, you can leverage the power of a WordPress. And the thing is, just like for the drag and droppers, the clients, they don't care. Because what the client want is a good price, something that looks nice and that just works and brings them more money, more clients. They couldn't care less whether you hand-coded it by hand or did it on WordPress or if you're a drag and dropper. They couldn't care less. If it works, if it makes them money, they're going to be happy. So yes, you can make good money with WordPress. Now, I think a way you can make a good living with WordPress is to move away from just simple websites and start to build application-style websites. And for that, you can follow the WP Tuts channel from Paul C. He teaches a lot of dynamic tutorials where you can build really complex websites. But like I said before, you can use Elementor Pro, Jet Engine, or ACF Pro and build kind of web applications. I built a web application for a car auto repair center. I mean, they have a few garages. And what happened is that they had some parts that they wanted to know, they wanted to have a centralized system where they know, okay, this garage has that part, so I don't need to order a new part from elsewhere. And initially they wanted the software to do that. But at the end of the day, when they told me what they wanted, this could totally be built with a few plugins. And they are pretty happy about the result. And like I've already mentioned, I know some people who sold WordPress website for really, really good price. They make good money. Now, of course, if you compare it to a full stack developer that's going to code a project for 2 months, of course, they're going to make more money, but only because you take into account the fact that, okay, they're highly qualified, but they spend more time, so they get paid more also. The WordPress Pro can make a website in a shorter amount of time. And once again, I'm not talking about really complex websites, even though it's possible. I'm talking about, I don't know, a 10-page website or a regular e-commerce website. They're going to be able to roll it and release it way faster. So they're going to get paid a good amount of money, but it's also relative to the time they spent. Of course, it's going to be lower than the full-stack developer, but they spend less time. So all in all, WordPress pros can make a good living, but it really depends on your sales skills if you are a freelancer. Now, of course, if you want to get a job as a WordPress pro, then it's another story. But even there, you need to negotiate your salary. Now, if you want to know why I went from front-end developer to WordPress pro / web designer / UI UX designer / WP consultant / whatever new name comes up, make sure you watch the video about my Elementor Pro ecosystem as well as the video about which WordPress plugin I recommend for professional work. It's a really good tool even though you are a web developer, I mean a full stack developer, and especially if you are a full stack developer. If you can code, sky's the limit.